diverse educational background. I went to college in St. Stephen's College, Delhi. Finished there a year and a half ago. And now I would like to lead my life giving myself the fullest expression of what I believe I have to say. I think what I have to say is determined a lot by the moment, by the fact that I react constantly to what I see and feel.
ಉದಾರನೇರು ಕತಿಶೈಲಜೇತ ಶ್ರೀ ವಿಶ್ವನಾಥ ಮಂತೀಶ್ರಾತ ದಯಾನಿಧಿತೋ ವಜಚರ್ಮಧಾರಿ ತದವೀರ ಶಂಭೋ ಮದಕೋಣತ ಕರ್ಪೂರ ಗೌರ ಸ್ಮರ್ಲೆ ವಿಷಾವ ಚಿಂತಾಹರಿದೋ ಗಜಕಾಶದ ಅಂತೀಶೈ ಸೂಚನಾ ವಿಚಾರಿ ತದವೀರ ಶಂಭೋ ಮದಕೋಣತಾರಿ
ಮೀ ಪ್ರಮೋದ್ ಕುಮಾರ್ ಕನ್ಸಾರಾ ಮೀ ಅದ ಎಫ್ ವೈ ಲಾ ಎಫ್ ವೈ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಲಾ
ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಇಯರ್ ಸೈನ್ಸ್
ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್
ಆಂಬಿಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಅ ಕೆಮಿಕಲ್ ಇಂಜಿನಿಯರ್ ವಿಶಸ್ ಟು ಜಾಯಿನ್ ಐಐಟಿ is in the NCC.
Of course, students must take interest in politics, but they should not take active part in politics. Mala pushkar mitra pan hai, parantu
has many friends, only boys.
I have read in many of the novels that girls are opposing any person to reach his goal. Therefore, I am of the opinion that girls are generally dangerous to the ambitious person.
In the mornings, I give tuitions. During the day, I go to office. In the evenings, I go to college. On holidays, I help my mother in the house. In spare time, I go to pictures. Mostly Indian films only. Marriage? Yes, I would like to get married. But I have friends here and I also go out with them. And they are of various communities.
मेरा नाम हैदर अली है
मैट्रिकुलेटेड इन 1965 में पास की कुडंट जॉइन कॉलेज फॉर लैक ऑफ मनी बट एज सून एज ही गॉट अ जॉब ही जॉइन कॉलेज विद अ लोन टेकन फ्रॉम द ऑफिस
मेरे गोस ने मुझे एडवाइस दी कि मैं पढ़ू भी और साथ साथ में सर्विस भी करूँ तो वहीं से मुझे लोन मिली और एक साल के बाद करीबन मैंने फिर अपनी
एम्बिशन इज टू बी अ चार्टर्ड अकाउंटेंट और अ कॉस्ट अकाउंटेंट हिज ओपिनियन इज दैट द प्रेजेंट जनरेशन इज नॉट गेटिंग द राइट काइंड ऑफ एजुकेशन फॉर इंस्टेंस डिसिप्लिन
जिसको सही मानों में तालीम मिलनी चाहिए वैसी नहीं मिल रही है जैसे कि डिसिप्लिन
मेरा नाम शिवशंकर हीरे
स्टडीड अप टू मैट्रिकुलेशन क्लास वांट्स टू बी अ टर्नर और अ फिटर
टर्नर फिटर कल काम करना चाहता हूं पिताजी की तबीयत खराब हो जाने की वजह से मुझे डेयरी का काम घर का काम करना पड़ता है
डजंट लाइक हिज फादर्स बिजनेस
काम करना
has to do it because his father has been very ill
ji mera naam asli to waise bahut lamba choda hai waise mujhe vijay lakshmi kapoor kaha karte
has always been fascinated by films and film stars wants to be a star at the present moment does character and bit parts
actors ko bhi dekhna chahti thi aur khud bhi actor banna chahti thi actress ji natija to abhi tak characters tak hi pahuncha hai छोटे छोटे करेक्टर कर लेती हूँ
एम्बिशन इज टू रीच द टॉप रंग ऑफ द लैडर एंड एंजॉय रेनाउन
मैं तो वैसे हीरो तो सभी अच्छे लगते हैं वैसे खासकर धर्मेंद्र है जितेंद्र है सुनील है राजकुमार है वैसे तो सभी अच्छे लगते हैं मैंने यही सोचा कि मैं भी इनकी तरह कभी बनूं और मैं भी इनकी तरह कामयाबी हासिल करूं ताकि दुनिया में मेरा भी नाम हो और मेरी वजह मेरी फिल्म को भी दुनिया देखे नाम होगी फलानी विजय कपूर फलानी गीता कपूर जो भी समझिए देखिए तजुर्बा की तो ऐसी बात है लोग तो मुझे एक से एक मिले हैं और एक से एक खतरनाक मिले हैं लेकिन जब खुद की चाल ठीक हो तो दूसरे चाल कैसे बिगाड़ सकते हैं आप तो जानते हैं
इंदुमती एन पटेल SIBA द्वितीय वर्ष JNJ कॉलेज ऑफ नडियाद
In the old days, education was considered bad for girls. Primary education was considered quite enough. Today, all this has changed. Women are in the forefront, both in college and in many social institutions.
આગળ કેરવણી વધતી ગઈ અને જયારે આજે અત્યારે કોલેજમાં કે બીજી કોઈ જગ્યાએ સ્ત્રીઓ જ પ્રથમ હોય છે, અમારી કોલેજમાં પણ એવું જ છે કે સ્ત્રીઓનું સ્થાન જ પ્રથમ છે.
College student, Tanjore. Parents stay in a nearby village. Father is a Mirastar. Wants to do BCom. Wishes to go abroad.
Foreign center padipadharku aasaipadugiren. Adarkagave naan English adhigamaga virumbugiren. Ippozhudhu kalyanam nikkulla aasaipadavillai. Enakku college padippu midithu vittu paakaye thodanga.
Not interested in getting married at present.
I don't like love marriage. My parents know much better than me. So let them settle it.
Mera naam Anand Devariya.
Comes from Mangalore where his father does any work that he gets. Came to Bombay with his older brother. Works in a hotel, earns 30 rupees a month, which he gives to his brother. Goes to night school, eventually will do BA and work in an office. It is difficult to know the minds of the young. In general, it would seem that most young people in India grow up in the atmosphere and perhaps the restraint of family and class. The problems and concerns are primarily personal. Education, finances, love, happiness. Ambitions seem to lie within the context of rights, duties and circumstances. Success and achievement outside of class and family is new. The consequence of an urban environment.
अंधारा रात्री काळी घागर घेऊन हेचाळ धडपडत जायचं आहे काळ्या पाणोठ्यावर. हे तर साक्ष नाही.
Is a pot of water. You must carry in the darkness of an unseen night and take care, for you do not know where you might stumble, when you might spill the water.
My name is Deepak.
My name is Chris Shepherd.
My name is Usha.
And if you think.
My name is Ajit Singh. That's all. being with friends and going out, you know, that type of life. You know, things like going to college and then in a big group, say 4 or 5 boys and 4 or 5 girls, going to a restaurant or going to a movie. So it's fun.
I'll tell you I am, what my motives.
I feel that friends are essential. You can't have fun when you're all alone, and you just have to have company to feel young and free and full of life. Oh no, I make it a point to see that I have friends from all communities, all social status. There's no difference at all in them, for me at least. I find variety is the spice of life.
Yeah, they get a pocket money. It's officially it's supposed to be 50 rupees a month, but somehow or the other it hikes up to 120 or something like that.
I hope that certain little lady comes by. She's not the kind of girl to be late for, and this one I'd break any date for. She doesn't have to ask what she's late for.
See, we study for, we do 11 years of school and then you do 4 years of college. and you find that you've just graduated. I mean, that too, it's very difficult to get a second class or a first class. I mean, ordinary students, fun-loving types and all, they just get a third. And unless you have something to fall back on, like your father's business or something, it's very bad that after doing so much of studying, you're just an ordinary person, you can't do anything much.
I have so much faith in him today that I really do not very much bother about him.
I plan to go to Britain sometime next March, as soon as I can get my business here cleared up, and I'm going to join a course for computer programming there, which my uncle has arranged for me. And maybe sometime later I'll be coming back to India regularly for some years. I'll be staying in Britain permanently. I'll be coming to India for holidays only.
Look, my mother came from my parents, they lived in villages. Have much scope for anything, very restricted life they had, and living in a city like Bombay, you get much more freedom, much more opportunity for everything. Independence has had a lot to do with it, but it mainly it's because of the city life.
I mean, it depends on the type of parents you have. In this generation also, you find some parents who are very broad-minded and very sporting and all, and they don't mind anything. But most of them, that is 90% of them, they're very orthodox, and they just like to stick to their old things, and they want you to do what they did and what their forefathers did. So it gets very frustrating and irritating and all of times here.
With confrontation, frustrations, a sense of injustice.
The students are doing the just thing because they have been demanding the things for so many years and they haven't got this. Now, regarding the climate in the rest of the country.
And the violence, yes. When you see the students rioting and all, it's all political.
For the last 5 years, we've been putting forward our demands in a very peaceful way. Only in 1963 also there was a general strike for the same things. But 4 years have elapsed since, but nothing has been done. From this you can gauge, it's not, you know, something that artificial, it's genuine, this trouble.
We get assurances from the government every year. Every year we go on, we set to agitate, every year certain assurances are given to us. And then we just get a few light bulbs here and there and one cooler on the second floor and then the whole thing is forgotten. We cannot tolerate this anymore. We feel hurt, we feel neglected. We feel, I mean, that the whole setup is so impersonal that we have no say in the matter. What we want is people who know something about it to come and govern us. What I want from this college is that it should equip me to practice the profession anywhere in the whole world.
This is what I demand from the college. And that's why I have come here hundreds of miles from my place. And if this college is not going to provide me all with these facilities, which are my just demand, which are my right, I'm certainly going to fight for them. This is what all the students here feel, personally.
Authoritarian methods of education. Few teachers, many students. No intrapersonal relationships.
Violence normally comes in areas where the legitimate channels of expression are blocked.
The violence in this country is not because of a lack of talent, but because of a frustration of talent.
The children have become more political minded, and that is one of the reasons.
The effects are terrible. Burning of examination papers, buses, halls, needless violence.
We often tend to criticize students and to say that various political parties have aroused them from political motives. I don't think that's quite just or fair to them, for the simple reason that they also have their grievances. Now, the stalk of violence as being increasing can be, first of all, a pattern of imitation. The second is that we are not creating an atmosphere of curiosity. We leave students with no definite guidelines whatsoever. Our educational policies have changed so often. We've changed the number of years of instruction of different languages. And in other cases, we have remained ossified. It is a symptom. It is a symptom not of a malaise, possibly, with students. It could be a symptom of a malaise with the teachers, of the lack of understanding, of the lack of encouragement, of the lack of facilities for the development of criticism and imagination.
The educational setup we have in this country is perhaps the biggest mistake we made in the post-independence years.
They are, after all, part of India. And if one part of India is really affected by the sense of insecurity, surely they also would express themselves in a similar manner. I do not mean the insecurity only of a job, of not knowing what will happen in political terms, in the possibility that one may not get the evening's meal because somehow or the other a new policy has been announced. What really do we give them as ideals or models? Secondly, are those ideals or models desirable or worthy of imitation? Have we ever examined the ideas or models, or do we accept them very much in the nature of the old ideal of education as something right because the guru has said so? Now, youth today cannot take that, and I don't think they should. They must be allowed to examine these ideals for themselves, to discuss them rationally and openly, to feel that they are in a partnership for the development of the country and not bearing a burden which has been charted by someone else. That there is a problem with youth has been the constant cry of everyone. It's not only our generation that feels this problem, it's the preceding generation and generations before that. But I believe that as part of growing up, there must be some alienation. Patterns. The patterns are inculcated at home, they are inculcated through the media of formal education. Not all these patterns are correct. They're not correct in that they do not fit a changing time. And therefore youth is bound to rebel until it finds its own place. Because until they accept or reject, you do not have a new culture that can be passed on.
But rebel? How? Violently? Blindly? No. Perhaps by establishing a dialogue. Perhaps by attempting to find solutions together with the older generation. In education, politics, for jobs. Can youth do this? Will the older generation provide the guidance?